nothing worse than a toothache so bad you have to go to the dentist. So today, Extreme Makeovers dentist Dr. William Dorfman is giving us secrets to keeping your teeth pain-free. Please welcome Dr. William Dorfman. Welcome to our show. Sean knows you well. Okay, let's get right to it. What is the primary cause of tooth pain?
You know what? It's infection. I mean, there's two ways you can have infection. You can have an infected tooth or infected gums. The big thing about tooth pain is you just waited too long. If it hurt, you waited too long. So with cavities, when they're small like this, you can treat them. It's just a little filling. But if you keep waiting until they get bigger like this, it actually goes into the nerve of the tooth. You end up needing a root canal, a crown, and all that. That's not what you want.
So that black stuff is infection.
That's bad. You don't want that. And you wait too long. The other thing is the gums. If you don't brush your teeth, take care of your teeth, and go to the dentist and get them cleaned properly, you'll see you get all kinds of calculus and tartar under the gums, and that causes the gums to become inflamed. So it's really infection. When it hurts, it's infection.
Okay, Sean, does he do this for you? Does he show you all of these?
Well, he'll tell you that my teeth are made of chalk.
They are.
And that I get more cavities than anybody else. But you know what's so annoying is his guidance is the same as every dentist's guidance throughout my entire life, and I'm still guilty of not flossing
enough. Which is what's going to make me get to how often should you brush? Okay, that's the first thing.
Ideally, you want to brush every time you eat, but we know that's not going to happen. So the ADA recommends at least twice a day, but really good.
Okay, and then what about the right toothbrush? Because it's all confusing now. There are hundreds of different toothbrushes.
There are, and you know what? People think if they use a really hard toothbrush, that's better. It's worse. You really want to use a really soft toothbrush.
So why do they sell those hard toothbrushes?
Well, because people buy them. Because people buy them. You see, here's the problem. When you use a really hard toothbrush, you brush your gums away. You get this really horrible recession. So you really want to use a very soft toothbrush and just kind of massage.
Electric
toothbrushes are great. The manual toothbrush should be used for 3 to 5 minutes. Well, we don't do that. Nobody does that.
Five minutes to brush your teeth?
Sean, you have to take time. You just brush once and that's good, okay? this is my segment. You sit here, be a good boy. When you come to my office, we'll fix your teeth.
Turning, righty then.
Turning.
All right, now.
But now, here's the thing.
Here's the thing.
If you use an electric toothbrush, they all have those little built-in timers. So it goes for 2 minutes, which is perfect.
Yeah. So if you're going to have electric, use the built-in timer.
And the sonic ones are great.
Okay, now talk to me about the toothpaste to buy. If you think we have 100 toothbrushes, we have 2,000 toothpastes.
Okay, the main thing about toothpaste, fluoride. And you want something with the ADA approval. Fluoride, people don't realize this, but your teeth are really porous. And the fluoride actually helps remineralize the teeth, and it makes it a little bit stronger so you don't get decay. So you want fluoride, and you don't want to use something that's too abrasive, because then, again, you're just brushing your teeth away.
All right, give me the right way to brush. You know
the
I'm
right
into teeth,
way to
y'all
brush.
Know this, okay?
I think we have a little video clip
okay,
here.
Okay, help us.
Basically, you want to take your toothbrush, aim it up at about a 45-degree angle, and then once you get it up into the gums, what you're going to do is just kind of massage the gums at that 45-degree angle. Don't do this. When you're scrubbing back and forth like this, what you're doing, again, is you're abrading away the gums. It's just not the best way to do it.
All right, baby.
And what about brushing your tongue?
You know what? That's a big misnomer. People think if you brush your tongue, you're doing something great, but you're not. You're just spreading the bacteria around. You want to take... What you want to do is you want to... In fact, I gave you guys a little kit. You have a little tongue scraper in there. You want to scrape your tongue and take all the bacteria off.
If you think it's ooh to do it, imagine ooh keeping it in there.
Yeah, exactly. Did you know that 90% of oral malodor is on your tongue? So if you don't do that tongue scraper, we have a little thing, it's a Breatherx tongue scraper. You put it on there, you scrape all the bacteria off, and you'll have better breath too.
Okay, you say another way to ensure healthy teeth is to floss a lot and pain-free teeth.
You
but there's
have
so
to
many
floss.
Flosses out there. Which one do you use?
Well, you know, the funny thing is patients come up to me and say, Doc, do I really have to floss? And I say, you know what, just floss the teeth you want to keep.
Because flossing is painful.
But if you don't floss your teeth, you're not really cleaning them.
But which one should you use?
The one that you'll use the most is the one you should use. So if you need something that's flavored or waxed, or you want something that will glide in between your teeth really well, ours has Zytex on it, so it actually helps with bad breath, too. So use something that's easy to use. It just slides between your teeth.
Okay.
Could you show us how to do it?
Yeah, the most important part of flossing is actually going up into the gums. Right. See, people usually start right here,
and they think
it isn't. If your gums are healthy, it isn't. And in fact, if you floss and it bleeds a little bit, don't think you're doing it wrong. It means you haven't been doing it enough.
Wait, what about the mouthwash? They say that that's the equivalent of flossing nowadays.
Yeah, and they're wrong.
Is that true?
Okay. And they're wrong.
You
can't just use a mouthwash. And if you are using a mouthwash, you want to make sure you use one that doesn't have alcohol in it. People don't realize this, but the leading mouthwashes have alcohol, and that doesn't help fight bad breath.
Wait, the strong one, the yellow one that I really like?
Yeah, we can't say the name, but
but I like that one.
No, you want to use one without alcohol. In fact, we have one. It's called Breatherx. It's got no alcohol, and it is one of the most effective ways to get rid of bad
breath. Why can't I use the one with the alcohol?
Because alcohol is bad. It's just bad for you. It will make you happy if you drink it.
He's a genetic mess, maybe, Shauna. Isn't some of it genes and you can't help it with your teeth?
You know what? It's true. Some people have stronger teeth than other people, and there are people that never get cavities. And then there's Sean. That's why I have a big house.
Are you saying that Gomez has bad teeth?
He adopted me, but that's a different story.
Sweetheart, we send you our best. Thank you, Sean, for being here with us. And Dr. William Dorfman. He's